All right, thanks so much, guys. We appreciate it very much. Brian, Jim, and all the officials at the MCAA. And speaking of that, the MCAA Fastest Trowel on the Block is right around the corner. The tenders are just now finishing up. There's a couple of them that are still laying some brick down, getting their setup just right. Remember, it's not just about speed. It's about accuracy as well. Next to me, he's called Maroney. And Maroney, I think we have a tough contest coming up here today. The block is a lot heavier. The time is a lot shorter. The speed and the stamina is required, just as these other contests. But as a judge, what in particular are you looking for? And go over some of the things that these guys are going to be looking at.
All right. Well, the competition essentially is a 20-minute competition. Each team is given those 20 minutes to lay as many blocks as they can on their 24-foot long wall. What our judges are going to be looking at is they're going to be looking for scoring them on plumb, level, story, voids, and craftsmanship. So ultimately what the teams have to do is they have to find a nice balance between craftsmanship and speed to score the most points and take home the top prize.
Now it's going to be a little bit more difficult. As we said, the block is a lot heavier. Is it about 30 pounds?
Give or take.
Give or take a little bit right there. But they're going to have a little bit of help because the Masons have two tenders. Now, what kind of advantage is it to have two tenders versus one?
Well, those tenders, when you have two of them, they can position the block just the way that you want them for maximum efficiency. They can make sure they're stacked up to a comfortable working height, and they can make sure that your mortar is at the right consistency as well so you can be as efficient as possible.
What are we going to look for a winning score today to brick? How many courses? What's the total brick? But throw a number out there. If the studio audience out there, if they're following along, they can see how many courses. What would be a good number we could look for today?
Historically, if you can get six courses laid, that's about 111 block. And if you can get 111 nice straight blocking, then you have a shot. So if you can see a guy out there that's got six courses, he's probably in the running.
Sounds good. Well, Maroney, thank you so much. I'm going to let you go so you can talk to your judges and get everybody ready. Good luck this year. We appreciate it very much. All right, the MCAA, Fastest Trowel on the Block. Now, it's $6,000 to the winner. And, of course, they're going to be using the Marshalltown trowels. They're going to get a nice trophy, too. And it is an incredible contest. It is the wildest 20 minutes you have ever seen. So when we come back, we're going to meet the judges, separate judges for that contest. We're going to meet those teams as well. The Fastest Trowel on the Block continues right after this. Don't go away. The tenders are almost done. Let's have a little music as we go into commercial break. Get these guys fired up.
The Mason Contractors Association of America has been representing the interests of the Mason contractor for over half a century. Having you as a member will truly make our industry stronger. From industry legislation to training and education, discover the valuable benefits of membership in the MCAA. Call 800-536-2225 or visit www.masoncontractors.org for more information.
Nothing signifies beauty more than building with stone masonry, and nothing compares to the benefits of installing it more than Quikrete Veneer Stone Mortar. Quikrete Veneer Stone Mortar is preferred by contractors and stone installers alike for its consistency, productivity, and quality. Project owners, architects, engineers, and contractors specify and use Quikrete Veneer Stone Mortar because it's pre-blended with sand to ensure each batch is the same all day long. And that keeps stone veneer projects structurally sound and beautiful over decades.
The Quikrete product keeps your mind focused on bigger problems that you don't have to deal with, making sure that your mortar is correct all the time. It's dialed in and it's always going to be the same.
One of the problems is in the morning, they're throwing full shovels in the hopper. But by midday to the afternoon later on, they're throwing 3/4 to 50% shovels in. You get a very inconsistent blend. And in this, the way that we're set up now, we don't have to worry about that. We don't have to break guys' backs. They're able to be on the wall, be more efficient doing masking or cleanup, and utilize that labor in a much more efficient manner.
There's not a lot of quality control on what's the actual mortar if they're doing it by hand from scratch materials. And as a general contractor, you know, I want the correct mixture. And if it comes in the sacks, I got reassurance that it's a good mix.
Quikrete Veneer Stone Mortar is versatile and can be used as a bond coat, scratch and brown coat, and even as a mortar joint grout. The easy-to-handle 80-pound bags make any masonry crew more productive.
For me, I like the premix because they have one spot. They just open up the bag, add the water, and off they go.
You take it off the pellet, you add water, and your guys are going. You can have less labors. You don't have the guys standing at the mixer all the time. You can keep a smaller crew. It's more cost-effective and productive.
And in the winter, it's especially, a problem when they just dump sand, and then you got to heat the sand because it freezes in the winter. And, you're 2 hours before you're making any mortar. And this way with the premix, they just open up the bags and mix it and off they go. And for me as a general contractor, it keeps the site a lot cleaner.
Your guys are more productive laying stone in the morning. You just add water.
More importantly, Quikcrete Veneer Stone Mortar is designed to provide stonemasons with a mortar that delivers superior workability, adhesion, and board life to maximize their productivity every day.
When it comes to architects, they know the product and quality that they get as far as color and workability. They know that it's going to be the same color from start to finish, and there'll be no variation. It spreads, it trowels nicer, it's a higher quality, and knowing that you're going to have a quality product from start to finish probably means more to us than anything else.
When using natural stone to build a project, skilled stone masons require a mortar that performs like no other. Quikcrete Veneer Stone Mortar is their choice. Combine the beauty of stone and Quikcrete Veneer Stone Mortar to ensure your next project delivers consistency, productivity, quality, and the great Quikcrete name and service you can count on.
It is time for the MCAA Fastest Trowel on the Block, $6,000 up for first prize. We're going to meet our judges and then meet our teams. So here we go, starting over on my left, your right. Judge number one, raise your hand as we do that. Install number one, Maroney. We just got done. Thank you, Mr. Maroney. We appreciate it. Install number two, Bobby Gladue from Artisan Masonry. Thank you, Bobby. Curtis Hoover from Anatundle County Public Schools. Heath Holdaway from IMS Masonry, that's in Utah. Alonzo Lewis from Alonzo Lewis Masonry. David Palocki from Foley Masonry and Tile. Eugene Johnson, Lake Marion High School. Robert Collins, Bricklayers and Allied Craft Workers. Nick Wilson with IMS Masonry. And Heath Reaney from Jacob Masonry and Adam Jacob from Jacob Masonry. Let's have a nice hand for all of our judges. Gentlemen, I'm going to excuse you and let you go to your stalls. All right, let's meet our teams right now. And I believe they got a special welcome as they come in, so we'll turn it over to our other camera crew. And as you've noticed, we do have multi-camera coverage here at the SpecMix Bricklayer 500. Nobody has it like this. We got the best setup thanks to our camera crew as well. All right, let's meet our teams. Team number one from Robertson Masonry. We have Tenders Jesse Fullen and Raymond Kinzer and Bricklayer Pascal Robinson. Let's give him a nice hand. Install number two from New Way Incorporated, Richie King and Tenders Justin LePage and Jeff Voss. Stall number three from New Dimension Masonry Incorporated, Howard Cole and Tenders David Jimenez and Martin Avendano. Stall number four from ASR Constructors, Mason Bob Christensen and Tenders Sean Romano and Victor Lozano. From Rhino Masonry, it is Chris Chi, your tender. Your Mason, excuse me, and Tenders Johnny Yazzie and Mario Estrada. Thank you very much, Chris. From Pioneer Masonry, your Mason Alfredo Cardenas and Tenders Garcia Flores and Armando Arrieta. From G&G Enterprises, your Mason Uriel Medrano and Tenders Filiberto Granados and Armando Leon. From Triple M Masonry, Mason Mike Kenez and Tenders Manuel Coronado and Isaac Perez. From AK Masonry, install number nine, Mason Larry Short and Tenders Levi Short and Tad Groose. Stall number 10 from Rene Latoie, Jr., Mason. From Conestoga College, it is Rene Latoie. The tenders are Rene Latoie, Sr. and Phil Keynes. And in stall number 12, rounding out the field, from Sutter Masonry, your mason, Arcadio Armenta, and the tenders, Guadalupe Aragon and Alvaro Landaverde. Let's have a nice hand for all our teams. We'll let them get into place. Thank you once again to Marshalltown and Johnson Level for handing out some great stuff. I'm going to talk to Mr. Johnson here real quick. What are you guys handing out to all them?
Well, today, Tom, we're handing out a 48-inch three-ply tongue and groove walnut and maple mason's level.
It's exactly what my cabinets are made of. I'm at home.
Yeah, that's beautiful wood.
No, that's great. I know you've been handing that stuff, and you got some more stuff for the masons a little bit later, don't you?
We do.
All right, awesome. We're going to see you a little bit later on over there for the chin-up challenge. Thank you once again for handing out everything. Also, Marshalltown as well. The contest is going to be getting underway in just a second. I'm going to give the judges just a second to get ready to go. I need to get the hands up from all the judges and make sure mud is being poured over there, and we're going to be good. And Brian, I think I'm going to throw it over to you right now. You got a mason handed over there. Who you got over there, Brian, and what's happening?
Thanks, Tom. I'm here with Mr. Art Conyers. Now, Art's competing in the Spec Mixed Bricklayer 500 today. However, in 1998, right, you took the championship of the fastest trowel in the block. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And that year we had, what, blue block and blue mortar?
Blue block, blue mortar. My shoes were blue for 5 years after that.
But after you won that money, you weren't sticking the blues anymore, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Anyway, what's it take to win this competition, Art? I mean, you competed on the Arizona State competition. You competed at Nationals. You won Nationals. What does it take?
Popeye arms.
Popeye arms? What about olive oil? You need her or not?
Yes, olive oil, too. It's very grueling. It's harder than the brick on your body. So it's stamina. It's got to click. And it's teamwork with the other two guys.
And now you are, if I'm not wrong, you're 58 years old. Is that correct?
Yeah, the cat's out of the bag.
The cat's out of the bag. So we would not see you in that? Or can you still do that block lane competition?
Well, I did it this year, but these guys, they're a lot younger than me. So I wouldn't be afraid to do it.
Well, let's get you in there next year. Thanks a lot, Art. I appreciate it. And good luck today, all right? There you go, Tom.
All right. Hey, thank you so much, Brian. I appreciate it. I'm over here at the other end of the arena. And I just want to let you know I'm waiting for the judges. Judges, could you let me know when all the tenders have loaded up and everything is ready to go? They're using the Gatorback mortar boards because we are getting ready to get our contest underway. And, of course, we want to thank our mudslingers. The mudslingers, they're the ones from all over North America. And if it wasn't for them, I don't know how we would get all of our mix out here because they got the hog troughs out there, and they are hauling stuff all day. I can't even begin to tell you how many tons that we have through there. But as you can see, everything is being made back there. The spec mix silos, the PA4000, that's what they're using right now. And they're filling up those troughs, and they are just hauling it out here. And if you think it's a lot right now, wait till the main event comes up, the spec mix bricklayer 500. These tubs are going to be moving. I don't even know how many tubs they do or how many tons, as I said, but it is incredible. So look for the mudslingers. They're the ones wearing the steel blue jerseys out there. The toughest tender is officially over. Now, our award ceremonies are going to be taking place at the end of the afternoon. Once the MCAA fastest trowel on the block is over, we're going to have that award ceremony first, and then towards the end of the day, we'll have the big awards for the toughest tender. Then we'll go down to third place, second place. We will then have the top craftsman. The top craftsman, of course, walking away with $5,000. And then, who is the world's best bricklayer? We're going to find that out a little bit later on. $5,000 plus sponsor prizes. And of course, the winner is going to walk away, or should I say, drive away. Odds are pretty good they're going to turn those plane tickets in and drive a brand new Ford back home. That's a 2012 F-250 heavy-duty crew cab 4x4. And if you want to see what it looks like, right behind me over there, you can see it up on the Hydromobile scaffolding. But it is time to start the event. The MCAA Fastest Trowel on the block. $6,000 up for first prize. Let's turn around. I'm going to go past the camera right here. I'm going to let you take a look at those guys. Judges, if you can hold your clipboards up in the air, please, to let me know we are ready to go. Tenders, You guys are ready to go? All the masons that are in the stalls at this point in time, I'm gonna need your trowels up in the air so I know that you are ready to go. I'm gonna count it down from five. Everybody that's in the studio audience, we would like to thank UNLV for supplying us with the competition clock. This is a 20-minute timed event. This is not like the toughest tender where it's speed and accuracy, but you're not timed. As the Spec Mix Bricklayer 500 is also timed, they have 20 minutes. Take a look at the clock. Here we go. Judges, if you're ready. Masons, if you're ready, I'm counting you down. Get ready with the clock in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Let's go, folks. Get these guys a round of applause. Let's get them going. Woo-hoo!
Okay, you guys can see how much time is left on the clock right now. The Masons, they're having added the tenders helping them for the MCAA Fastest Trowel on the block. I'm going to turn it over to Brian Carney right now. He's over in the crowd chatting with somebody. Hey, Brian, who have you got over there, my friend?
I'm over here with Bob Burkhardt from Arizona Walls. Is that a masonry contractor? Flooring? Would you ever lay block in your life? Well, let's talk about it. What's it going to take to win this event?
That the consistency, I've watched several of them, and a couple of them have got it, and they all have it, trust me, but I see a couple that are going to be positive finishers.
So these guys are fairly young guys. If we had to get you out there, how many years back do we have to go to get you out there?
No way.
He's not going to do it, guys. Back to you, Tom.
Hey, thanks so much. All right, I'm going to turn it over to Jim O'Connor real quick. He's going to give an update. Jim, how much time do we have on that competition clock over there from UNLV? And let me know who's off to a good start.
Just under 16 and a half minutes, and these guys are flying right now. I want all you Mason contractors in the crowd to understand that this is a 20-minute race. You can't expect your guys to work as hard as these guys are right now. But we got guys doing leads. We got guys throwing bed in the mortar, bed joints, and they're flying. They're really moving. I know a bunch of you guys that are masons would love to have these guys on your crew. Tom, what's going on with you?
Okay, I've got Nick Lahoviak, and Nick is with Spec Mix. And Nick, you got an incredible demo over here. This is like having your own concrete plant that's actually portable. Tell me what's going on over here.
Well, what we have here, Tom, is we have the spec mix, DTW wet mix over one of our silos. As you just said, it turns our silo system into a portable batch plant for mason contractors on their job. Now they're able to get anywhere from as much as one pail of ready mix or of grout right on their job site, all the way up to 50, 60, even 70 yards in a day. The machine will do over 8 yards in an hour, keeping up with any mason crew.
All right, now what are we going to see here today? What is the demonstration? Because I'm going to talk to Raleigh in just a second. What is exactly going to happen?
We're going to turn on the wet mix. It's going to start making core fill grout. We're going to dump it directly into a Mako pump. That pump is then going to pump this wall full of grout in a matter of minutes.
That's absolutely amazing. And this is also remotely operated, if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Not only is the wet mix remotely operated, but Raleigh will show how his pump is remotely operated. So talk about efficiency. You get up on the scaffold, start my mixer, start my pump, and away we go.
More remotes for men. That could be trouble for the wives. Let's go over and talk to Raleigh Cox. Raleigh, good to see you again. What do we got over here, buddy? We got a huge pump.
We got a Mako C30. It's a standard of the industry. It's bulletproof. It's a mechanical pump. Just dead stupid simple, or I wouldn't be operating it. And we've got this thing ready to go. We're just going to complete the circle. We're going to take the spec mix, put it right straight into the wall. No buckets, no hauling around in mud tubs. Nothing. We're just going to make it right on the job site and put it in. We can grout exactly when we want to grout. No questions asked.
And you got a remote switch as well that you're going to be working it.
I fight my wife for it on the couch at night. I keep it with me close and tight to my heart. But yes, sir, we operate the entire pump. We operate the pumping speed and everything right here off the remote.
And as you told me a little earlier, don't give the wife the switch when you're taking a bath because she's liable to fill the tub up with grout and then she gets the house.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, let's get the thing started underway. All right, Nick, I'm going to let you fire up the D2W. We're going to be doing that. That's going to be remotely done. There they go. There goes the pump. Let's get the camera over here. Take a look at this. There's the pump going over here. Bring the camera. You can see what's going on right here. You can see how that's coming out. He's filling that up. See if we can get that pulled out. There you go. And this is just a matter of minutes before we can do that. You can see how fast this is coming out right now. Nick, Raleigh, come on over here for just a second. Now, how fast is that pouring out, Raleigh?
That's coming out of there at about 7.5 yards an hour. So we'll fill this thing up in no time.
And Nick, this has got to be incredible. As we said, it is a concrete plant that you can basically take with you. How much money are we saving? I mean, you can't even count the dollars in efficiency on this, can you?
Imagine never waiting for a ready mix truck on a job site. Gets to be 3 o'clock, I shut it down. Hey, if I need to go another half an hour, no demurrage, no wait time. No, nothing. It doesn't get any better than this for efficiency, Tom.
All right, Nick, Raleigh, thank you so much. We appreciate it. I'm going to let the camera watch this as we fill it up, and I'm going to walk around here because I need to check on, once again, see how these guys are doing. Jim, Brian, I'm going to turn it over to you for a second. I need to know how many courses we got up. Who's leading right now? Who looks good?
Hey, we have a couple of guys with two courses already in. A lot of guys have two courses. You can't really judge who's winning because some guys are doing leads, some guys are doing straight lines. It just looks great, and they're moving fast. What do you think, Brian?
Well, we're approaching the 50-block mark already, so these guys are moving, trust me.
There's 18 block in a line, so you guys can do the math. There's a bunch of guys working on his third course. Many have two already laid with leads, so it's really hard to judge who's going to win this thing.
You know, I know Maroney was talking about last year about 111 block, about six courses. I believe one year we actually had about 120 to 125 block. Somebody was almost up to eight courses. So I'm not sure what's going to happen this year, but they're throwing it up pretty fast.
Well, one thing they do have back there, they have jump boards. So as they go higher, Tom, they can jump on these boards and keep on going so they're not killing themselves and raising block above their head.
And that's what the tender's job is. They've got to get that set up, correct?
Exactly. It's a real team sport, obviously. That's why we have two tenders and one block layer.
And Jim, I know consistency is extremely important with this because that's what these guys count on when they're loading that block. What's the secret to all that stuff?
Well, like I said, the great thing you can learn here is so many people doing it a different way. You can learn how they are and what might work for you. But
All I see is a lot of good brick and block layers right now.
Well, you notice it. That one's got one tender working the mud, keeping it going off those gator bag mortar boards. And the other one's always staging the block, getting it ready for the block layer to put them in the wall. So, again, these guys are working in concert to make this thing happen.
Hey, if you wonder what's going on right now, these are our sponsors that are throwing out some goodies. We promised some good stuff out there. All these hats that are flying out. I see some Spec Mix hats. Who wants a hat? Come on, we got plenty to go around. Everybody get something. Throw that stuff around. We got plenty to go. Who needs, anybody need a hat over here? Hey, we got to show some love over here on this side. Here we go. Six courses. We've got 7 minutes left, but it looks like they might go further than that. What do you think?
In a 20-minute contest, these guys are already at foot scaffold height. Let's hear it for them. That's amazing.
Come on, let's hear it, crowd. Root them on. Let's go.
And here at number one, he started with the foot scaffold, so he was confident he was going to run that baby up. That's amazing.
You know, and we have last year's winner here as well, and if I'm not mistaken, I believe it was right around 115, 116. I believe that was the winning score. That could be beaten here today.
It sure looks like it. And, you know, we figure in Chicago, but 120 to 150 a day is probably not a bad day. So this shows you in 20 minutes. These guys are amazing.
All right, let's turn up the music right now. Let's cheer these guys on. We only got about 6 minutes left. Come on, let's hear it. Crank it up a little bit. A little over 5 minutes. Come on, guys, make some noise out there. We'll be right back.
You know, if you want to, you can watch these guys and watch the way they do all this and how quick they are right here. Right in here, install number 4. I believe that's Bob Christensen, if I'm not mistaken. You can watch the way that they do it. It's an absolute fluid motion, which is why these guys can do this so quick. It's like a dance. You know, we're here in Vegas. These guys are doing a block dance right now because it is just a continuous motion, one after the other. Now, some guys are doing a block at a time. Other guys, they're laying a lot of the mud down, and then they're just putting block on top of block on top of block. Now, Jim, I got to ask you, doing this, is there an advantage one way or another when you're doing this type of competition?
It's personal preference, and I'm sure these guys have practiced this, and they figured out what's the best for them, because I'm telling you, this is a block party.
It's amazing, because I'm watching this guy over here in stall number 3, and I mean, he's running the mud and then running all the blocks, and the other guys are doing a block at a time, but yet he's at the same level as all of them. So it just depends on how you do it.
However it works for you. And some of these guys, all of these guys are amazing. Most of them have 90 block laid already. And we have 4 minutes, 3.5 minutes left.
We got about 3 minutes and 10 seconds left. Now, when it comes to cleaning and tooling the walls, what do you do to prepare that ahead of time? How do you make sure that there's not a lot of the cleaning and tooling so you don't have a lot of points to duck through? What's the key there?
Well, these guys are craftsmen, and you can see that they knock off as much of the mortar as they go along, and then they're going to have a few minutes to clean up afterwards. And these walls are straight, they look great, and it's a shame we got to take them down when it's all done.
You know, what happens if we don't do that? What happens if they don't get a lot of that mud off right away? How can that affect you during the cleaning and tooling?
Well, most of these, most of the time, they're a finished wall where they're going to paint, and you need to have a smooth surface, and it looks like they're all taking really good care of that right now.
All right, well, we're going to let the music play for the final 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Only a little over 2 minutes left. Let's crank up the music. One more song.
Guys.
Come on.
Woo!
Turn it up. Here we go. I'll tell you what, right now I am looking at probably 4 or 5 walls that could win, maybe 6. An awesome display. Let's have a nice hand for all our contestants right there. Okay, right now, The Masons are going to get a five-minute rest period. We're going to give them a chance to chill out. When we come back from our commercial break, it'll be time to clean and tool. Once they are done, then we'll move on to our main event, the Spec Mix Brick Layer 500. But they're not done yet. We'll be right back with the MCAA Fastest Trowel on the Block. Don't go away.
Boral Bricks is the nation's largest brick manufacturer and distributor. The Terre Haute plant is LEED Gold certified, a zero waste facility that uses recycled materials, low water and electricity, and minimal packaging. Boral uses methane from a nearby landfill to fuel its kiln. The process takes local minerals, grinds them, adds water, and mixes before cutting the bricks and firing them. Fully automated systems and robotics ensure human safety and increase production capacity, producing 120 million bricks per year. Innovative, efficient, quality. Boral Bricks.
There's work. And then there's heavy-duty work. The kind of work that makes civilization possible.
Whether you're a bridge painter in Michigan or a farmer in Arkansas or a roughneck out on the Gulf or maybe a miner here in Colorado, you all seem to have certain things in common. A sense of humor, willingness to roll up your sleeves, do whatever it takes to get the job done, and an awareness that without the right tool, you're pretty much out of business.
Which means the tools they choose become as much a part of who they are as sweat, muscle, and backbone.
Everywhere I go, this is the tool I see.
The Ford Super Duty. In overwhelming numbers, this is the tool the guys in the field trust to get the job done.
So Ford went out in the real world to see who was using what on real job sites. What they found was kind of amazing. But this is about more than impressive numbers. It's about you, hardworking men and women who get up every single day and get the job done. You know who you are. Drop us a line. Tell us about your tough job. Maybe we'll show up with a camera crew, give you a chance to prove it.
Hydromobile is a privately owned Canadian company that specializes in the design, manufacturing, and distribution of mast climbing work platforms for the construction industry. Our engineering team continuously improves our line of products and quality levels, helping Hydromobile stay ahead of the competition and remain the industry leader.
Angelus Block, Southern California's premier source for concrete masonry and interlocking concrete pavement products. Founded in 1946, Angelus Block Company Incorporated is the leading producer of concrete masonry and interlocking concrete pavement products in California and distributor of a variety of top-of-the-line products that enhance the design and value of projects they supply. Our full-service staff is available at every stage of a project to assist designers, specifiers, and contractors in optimizing material selection. Check their full line of products at angelusblock.com.
We just got done with the MCAA Fastest Trowel on the Block, so I'm going to turn around real quick, and I'm going to turn it over to the guys out there. Gentlemen, you have 5 minutes to clean and tool your wall. On your mark, get set, go. 5 minutes. 5 minutes to tool and clean your wall. Brian Carney right now is with Maroney, and he's going to talk about the tooling and cleaning and really get into the details of why it's important to do it right. Brian?
Thank you, Tom. Maroney, you're a block layer, you're a bricklayer. How many years have you been doing this?
15.
And what else do you do in terms of helping the masonry trade become stronger? Aren't you an instructor?
Yeah, that's right. We teach an apprenticeship program in the state of Arizona as well.
So tell us why tooling is so important in the field of masonry.
Well, every good mason knows that tooling is a huge part of the job. It's putting the finishing touch on a beautiful wall. So if you have a really nice wall and you do a bad tooling job, it's not going to look too good. And the opposite is also true.
So it's a big part of the judging of these walls, obviously.
Yeah, it's huge. We're counting every void that's left. When these guys are done tooling that side of the wall, we'll check and see if there are any voids left, and they get points deducted for every void that we find.
Well, Tom, I'm telling you, tooling is a big part of the puzzle. So all that said, we got to watch these walls close because it's going to be a big part of the job.
I mean, it really is. And if you watch behind him, you can see, you know, the same way that they lay the brick, there is just a method. There's just a way that they do it to knock it out real quick. You can see how these guys are doing it. It's a dance. It really is a dance the way they do it, and they're doing it quick. 2.5 minutes left, guys. 2.5 minutes left to clean and tool the wall. I just, you know, it just amazes me how fast they can work and throw up this block. You know, it's just incredible.
Well, like Art Kanye said earlier, past champ, this really is physically taxing work. It really is. Maroney, you know, you've been doing it for a long time.
Absolutely. It takes a strong back, takes a good eye, and like Art said, it's teamwork. Being able to just work together as a team, not miss a beat.
So what part of the body aches more, the back, the forearms, the biceps, what is it?
I think it depends on the guy. Sometimes it's your hands, sometimes it's your back. The elbow can start to ache a little bit too.
But what really, in the end, when you win that $6,000 check, what part of the body feels the best?
It all goes away at that point.
I think it's your wallet, to be honest with you.
That's right. A little over a minute, guys. A little over 1 minute left. A little over 1 minute left. We'll count you down from the 1 minute mark. 1 minute right now. 1 minute right now. 60 seconds. You can see the tenders. They're not allowed to touch the wall, but they can point out some of the voids and let the mason know where some of those voids might be so they can help him. But it is up to the mason and the mason only to touch the wall. It's a big deduction, or is it disqualification if the tender touches anything, Maroney?
It's a deduction. The judges are paying attention. If they see that happen, it'll be a point deduction on that.
Okay, looking at the clock right now, we're checking it out. We've got ourselves 30 seconds, 30 seconds. Finish it up, guys. Music till the end. Here we go.
Don't be afraid to cheer on your mason. Come on, let's go. They need it.
Trowels up. Trowels up. Trowels up. Let's give them a nice hand, everybody. To the masons and the tenders. Heck of a job. That's probably the wildest 20 minutes that I ever see during this. I know the Spec Mix Bricklayer 500, it's an hour-long grueling competition, but for a 20-minute span of speed and stamina, it's absolutely unbelievable. All right, the Fastest Trowel on the Block. Now, we're going to be awarding all those prizes a little bit later on. This is when we start giving away the goods. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a nice hand for all our Fastest Trowel on the Block teams. Let's hear it for them. All right, here we go. We are ready to go. We're going to start with third place and work our way up. Our third place winner is going to get $1,500 in cash, a Bosch 12-volt max impact driver, Marshalltown tool bag containing the trowel, tape measure, beaver tail brush, joint, jointer, and tuck pointer, a $100 product certificate from Steel and a Johnson level third place level from Rhino Masonry, Chris Chi. Chris, let's give him a nice hand. Tenders, Luis Vargas and Ricky Esparza. Come on up. Congratulations, guys.
I'll tell you, Tom, Arizona kicks out some good block layers. They're always in the running every single year, the Arizona boys.
Every year from Mesa, Arizona, and we have our fine folks from the MCAA back there. They're going to be shaking hands. They're going to be giving away all the prizes. All right, in second place, $2,500 in cash. The Bosch 12-volt Max 3-tool combo kit, the Marshalltown tool bag loaded up, a $300 product certificate from Steel, and a Johnson level and tool second place level. From Riverside, California, ASR Constructors, Bob Christensen. Tenders, Sean Romano and Victor Lozano. Let's hear it for them. Bob, congratulations. Another fine job. Come on up and get your goods. Your winner from Phoenix, Arizona, Triple M Masonry, Mike Canez, and Tenders, Manuel Coronado and Isaac Perez. Let's hear it for them. You were right, Brian. Arizona once again.
Well, this isn't Mike's first rodeo. I know that. You've
come
been
on over here, guys.
Block lately.
Let's have a nice hand for all of our contestants.